Welcome to Session 2. Session 2 is going to deal with the first one-third of the model. And so it's entitled Visualization Plus Emotion, because these are the most effective techniques that relate to this part of the model. So we're going to be discussing this first one-third section of the model right here. These other sections, the second and third section, are going to be covered in later sessions. If we expand out and just look at this first part of the model, something becomes very, very obvious about it, and that is that it deals primarily with symbolic experiences. If your consciousness is located primarily on this section of the continuum, in this part of the model, your primary day-to-day experiences are all symbolic. You may never have that you can recall non-symbolic experiences. Or if you do, it will be probably very, very, very slight. So what do we mean by symbolic experiences or symbolic consciousness? Well, if you recall from our first video, from our first session, symbolic consciousness is basically your normal everyday consciousness. It's also referred to commonly as egoic consciousness. And it's the dominant consciousness. It's the dominant way of experiencing the world. For I personally estimate about 99% plus, and I think it's probably a big plus of the population. I think it's way less than 1% of the population that has non-symbolic consciousness as their dominant way of experiencing the world. Now, there are no hard numbers on this. Some people argue that maybe as many as 30% of the population have had some glimpse of non-symbolic consciousness. I personally disagree with those studies, and I think that the number is much, much smaller. I would be surprised if 10%, and frankly, even if 5% of the population had had a glimpse of non-symbolic consciousness in any type of actual meaningful way. But out of that number, a much, much smaller percentage of the population has as their dominant way of perceiving the world on an ongoing basis non-symbolic consciousness. So if you're located on this part of the continuum, you're really in the bulk of humanity in the sense that you're primarily experiencing the world through being deeply rooted in symbolic consciousness. So what is symbolic consciousness? When I'm talking about that, what does that really mean? Well, waking, dreaming, and even deep sleep all involve symbolic consciousness. Deep sleep has, up until very, very recently, as I'm making these videos, been thought to be a non-symbolic mode of consciousness. Many, many spiritual researchers talk about deep sleep being a way that in every day people dip into non-symbolic consciousness but simply don't remember it. Well, there's emerging research that suggests that there are certain types of dreams that are possibly occurring in deep sleep. And when you have dreaming, you have symbolic consciousness. So it's looking like these three types of consciousness may all be forms of symbolic consciousness. Now, why do we refer to them as symbolic consciousness? Well, it's because all of your thinking and perceiving and experiencing is really mediated through symbols. It's expressed in symbols. It's dealt with manipulating symbols. If you're looking at this screen is represented as a symbol in your mind. And it's not just the screen. Even emotions are represented as symbols in your mind. The language that I'm speaking to you in right now, it's all a symbol in your mind. So you might think of symbols as, you know, dollar signs or something like that. Certainly those are symbols in everyday parlance. But what we're talking about really is taking a step back and saying that the mind really works normally in symbolic consciousness. And as a function of that, it expresses everything in symbols, it stores everything in symbols. And when we think, what we're really doing is we're really manipulating those symbols that our mind has stored. So you're in good company here if you're located on the first one-third of the model, because by far, most people are located here on the model.